Now, we're up to our long-distance dedication. And this one is about kids and pets and a situation that we can all understand, whether we have kids or pets or neither. It's from a man in Cincinnati, Ohio, and here's what he writes. Dear Casey, this may seem to be a strange dedication request, but I'm quite sincere, and it'll mean a lot if you play it. Recently, there was a death in our family. He was a little dog named Snuggles, but he was most certainly a part of... Let's go start again. I'm coming out of the record. Play the record, okay? Please. See, when you come out of those up-tempo goddamn numbers, man, it's impossible to make those transitions. And then you got to go into somebody dying. You know, they do this to me all the time. I don't know what the hell they do it for, but goddamn it, if we can't come out of a slow record, I don't understand it. Is Don on the phone? Okay, I want a goddamn concerted effort to come out of a record that isn't a fucking up-tempo record every time I do a goddamn death dedication. Now, make it, and I also want to know what happened to the pictures I was supposed to see this week. It's a last goddamn time I want somebody to use his fucking brain to not come out of a goddamn record that is, that's up-tempo, and I gotta talk about a fucking dog dying.
Hey, freaks, it's Thursday, November 15th, 2018, coming up on the program today. Uh-oh, SpaghettiOs plus stupid fucking models won't call for an ambulance. Another rapper covers Vanessa Carlton, and was one man plotting to launch turd torpedoes or drop dirty bombs? Find out today!
It's the Distorted View Show with Tim Henson.
My doctor wants to dilate my asshole to the size of a fucking coconut.
Yeah! Hey, freaks, Tim Henson back here with you for a Thursday podcast. Got a great show for you today. Instead of it being sideshow exclusive, today we're doing a program for everyone. Tomorrow's show will be sideshow exclusive, and then on the weekend we'll be doing a show for everyone again. Why? Because yesterday we did not do a show, at least in the traditional sense. I posted a, like 5-minute little dumb distorted view cartoon. Hope you all got a chance to see that, and I hope you all liked it. It's my first attempt, so if you... didn't like it. I'm sorry. I've been working on it for a while, and I wanted to finish it up yesterday, and that's why there was no show. Kind of lost track of time finishing it up there. But normally, you know, if I do these little animations in the future, they'll just pop up on the YouTube channel, or it'll be a sideshow exclusive or something. It won't interrupt the show normally. So hope you enjoyed that. I've got a lot of audio to share with you today. First up, I need to defer to you on this one. I've got a clip from Let's Make a Deal. You know that daytime game show that airs after The Price is Right, hosted by Wayne Brady. In this clip, it's very short. He's interviewing two contestants that came together.
That's awesome. Now, how long have you guys been together?
About 6 months.
That's it? It's new. Oh, it's newish.
We're friends.
What a bitch, right? Obviously, this guy thinks that you're in a relationship. He's just said so on national television. Do you really have to correct him and break his heart all at once? And it shouldn't even be because, like, I don't want everyone in the world to think we're dating together. You know who watches Let's Make a Deal? People in waiting rooms. That's it. It's like the over 70 crowd and people waiting to change their brake pads. You know, not everyone is going to know you're, or think you're dating just because you're on TV. All right, so it goes on here.
Oh, it's newish.
We're friends. We're just friends, but he wants it.
Can we talk about this not in front of everyone, Jesse?
I'm single.
It's complicated.
I'm single, guys. I'm single.
What?
Oh, no. We're really good friends.
All right, so, guys, do you think this is bullshit? I'm usually pretty good at spotting these fake clips, and my spidey senses are tingling. Oh, Stan Lee. There's just something about how he kind of goes for the microphone. Like, he's very eager to speak.
Can we talk about this not in front of everyone, Jesse?
And he's, like, looking around. I don't know. I think he's...
I'm single.
It's complicated.
I'm single, guys. I'm single.
What?
Oh, no. We're really good friends.
So we have this.
I don't know, the girl's kind of convincing. And I could be wrong about the guy because there's so much cringe involved. His world is collapsing around him. It very well could be real. What do you guys think? Regardless, she's a bitch, right? She could have, like, spared his feelings, and then after the appearance, right after Let's Make a Deal is done taping, she could say, you know, like, hey, I know you think we're together, you mentioned it on TV, but I want to slow things down. I think we should just work on being friends. You're kind of gross, and I don't know. She could have let him down a little easier. All right, let's move on. There's a website for Donald Trump fans. If you voted for Donald Trump and you're standing by your man, check out keepandbear.com. One amendment to protect them all. I thought it was just a pro-Second Amendment website. No, they are firmly sucking on Donald Trump's dick. They've got a full line of DT merchandise. And it's not like normal Donald Trump shit that you see, you know, like Trump bumper stickers, MAGA hats. This goes well beyond that. How about Santa Trump Christmas cards? It's Donald Trump dressed like Santa. He looks like the Coca-Cola Santa. It's very like Norman Rockwell-esque. Then there's also, in addition to the Christmas cards, you can get a Christmas print of The Night Before Christmas with Trump as Santa. And also, the words have been changed. And they're included in the poster, of course. Now, in the picture, it's very small, the text, so I can't make out all of it. But I think it goes like this. 'Twas the night before Christmas when all through the house, every patriot was happy that Hillary got trounced. The stockings were hung by the chimney with care in the hopes that St. Donald Trump would soon be there. The children were nestled all snug in their bed while visions of a socialist free nation danced in their heads. Okay, you get the idea. It goes on and on. I see the words eight MAGA reindeer later on in the poem. It gets weirder, though. There are Donald Trump coloring books. There are bumper stickers like heaven has a wall and strict immigration policies. Hell has open borders. And it's kind of clever. There's also a 12x12 limited edition print entitled Trump Surfing the Red Wave. And there Trump is, dressed as a surfer, on his surfboard, riding on in the water that is all red. There's Trump collector coins. And then the weirdest thing, and I have to think they're going to get sued over this one. They've got Lego sets you can purchase. You know, building blocks. They've created a Build the Wall Lego set. It's just like a large black platform piece, and then there's a brick wall. A bunch of pieces of blocks that make up a wall, and then there's a minifig of Donald Trump. Now, it's not actually called Lego, although the font that they're using looks just like Lego, right? But instead, it's MAGA. MAGA blocks. You can also purchase other minifigs, like Hillary Clinton, of course. She's in a jumpsuit. The minifigs actually look really good. That's the part that I think is going to piss off Lego, because they look just like Lego characters. If you want to see what this thing looks like without visiting the website, I've made it today's featured image over there at distortedview.com and superfreaksideshow.com. They sell the Trumpy Bear. They sell t-shirts, Donald Trump cologne, Success by Trump, and Empire by Trump. Those are deodorants. But I think they also have colognes and stuff. I'm guessing they were created like before he was president. They've got bobbleheads, President Donald Trump duckies, the Trump Infinite Love bracelet, and you can actually purchase a Donald Trump official bust. Just a bunch of crap. If you love Donald Trump, check out keepandbear.com. You guys know who Janice Dickinson is, right? She's like an old supermodel. And she's been like a judge on America's Next Top Model. She's had her own reality show. She's a fucking mess. And she's a lot more important in her head than she is in real life. How do I know this? Because she's starred in a season of Celebrity Rehab with Dr. Drew. And no real celebrities go on that show. Another good indicator is she goes on like reality shows in different countries. Like she'll star in the Norwegian version of Big Brother. That's something you don't typically see with your stars like Jennifer Aniston or Colin Farrell. I've got a clip here from one of these foreign reality shows. Most of the, I don't know, house members or contestants or whatever speak jib-jab language, but Janice Dickinson refuses. She speaks English.
Yeah, you're so spoiled. When I walked in the house, I didn't include you because I looked and I saw you were such a little sloven little girl.
apparently this foreign bitch is a little messy.
Much longer are you gonna ever have this pig shit?
I promise.
Okay, goodbye.
Me and you.
No, you know, I don't give a shit about me. It's about you, bitch.
I think this is actually like a foreign version of America's Next Top Model, maybe? It has to do with modeling.
You know what? I'm here as your friend. Understand this right now. I didn't fly all the way from the United States of America. Damn that bitch.
She just downed a whole bottle of wine, or a whole glass of wine.
Why do you want to be in front of the camera?
She's asking one of the girls, what's her motivation for modeling?
I want to be in new places and see people and learn fashion. This is like the first time when I've tried this, and I love it.
Too bad you're ugly.
I kind of like this Janice Dickinson. She's tell it like it is. That's great, you want to be a model. But you're fucking hideous. You're bow-legged and you got buck teeth. I'm pretty sure I've seen models with those two afflictions. Doesn't necessarily mean you're excluded from the modeling industry. Yeah, I guess she's at a dinner with all the models here, and she's getting progressively more drunk.
You could all be almost my grandchildren. But you know what? It's all right. Yeah, don't you get like that so snippy with me.
She goes back and forth. A lot of drunks do this, where they're like super sweet and then mean. I want you to all know I love you so much. What the fuck are you looking at, asshole? I'll beat the shit out of you, not you, because you're my best friend and I love you so much. We need to do this more often. I love being around you. Why does everyone hate me? I hate my life. But the food here is so good. Oh my god. Does anyone want to split fries?
Yeah, don't you get like that so snippy with me. All right. Because I have a son. She's so cute. You might even be there. You have to be respectful, always. You all have it all. Depends on the final choices of Finland's Next Top Model.
Oh, okay, there's our answer. Finland's Next Top Model. Meanwhile, Janice continues to get more drunk.
I want to be a model because, all right, I want to pose, okay? I want to pose. I want to walk. I want to eat. I want to sleep. I want to shit. I want to be that model. I want to dream.
Today, I learned that models shit. I thought they ate so little, their body just absorbed everything.
I want to learn about photography. I want to eat, sleep, shit, eat whatever it takes to be a model.
I want to eat, shit, eat that shit, and then shit the shit. Who knew there was so much eating and shitting when it comes to modeling? Thank you, Janice Dickinson. Then Janice storms off. And she walks downstairs to leave, but I believe she trips and falls on the stairs.
Yes. Guys, y'all
Oh, yeah. Yeah, she tumbled there. You can't really see her. The models slowly get up from their meal right at the table, and they check on her. It's like she twisted her leg, maybe?
Fuck you all.
Yeah, blame it on the models. Fuck you all!
Have you ever actually done this?
Oh, hold on, I want to hear that again. Fuck you all.
Fuck you all. Have you ever actually done this stairs? This is not bullshit. This is not an act.
We saw it.
Yeah, you what you see.
Don't run in ever.
Like Janice doesn't believe you. I don't believe you saw me fall. What a weird thing to argue.
Janice Dickinson on kaatunut meidän rappasissa ja
siis koko homma niin tuntuu tosi Janice here.
Mä naurettiin siellä ylhäällä, kun mä oltiin ihan
shokissa. Like an ice pack on her.
My leg isn't working. So I want the guy to come and help me out. Do something, you stupid models! Call a fucking ambulance! You're so stupid!
Alkoi huutaa.
She kind of reminds me of Tan Mom there. The models are kind of dumb. They're all just standing around. No one is calling for help.
Call a fucking ambulance! Figure something out! All you do is pose. You're all so fucking dumb.
Janice is agreeing with us that models are dumb. All you do is you pose and you stand. And sometimes you walk. Pick up a phone. Call the ambulance. Actually do something. Oh, I hope Janice is getting the help she needs. All right, let's move on. I've got a public freakout here. Actually, a racist freakout. And I know I've received a call or two from people who don't like hearing these racist freakouts. But this one's a little bit different because he's also a meth head. And he starts off by screaming about faggots. Oh, right there. You have to listen closely, but there was a faggot there.
Faggot. I don't steal nothing. I'm a fucking good person, you fucking nigger. Okay? Stay out of my face.
Certainly sounds like he's a good person. So this guy was accused of stealing in a store, and that's where this is taking place.
Yeah. Right here. Up your ass, you fucking punk.
Here you go, bro.
David,
next time, stop.
I paid for that, sir.
I need you out of my store. No, you haven't.
You know what? Fuck you, niggers. That's $5, you fucking punk ass nigger. Yeah, I paid for it. Fuck you. I'll wait for the coffee, dude.
Well, where's your receipt? It's easy to figure this one out. You just purchased something. You should have the receipt. You couldn't have lost it in the time it took you to go from the checkout lane to the door.
Get out of my store.
Oh, wait, right here.
Get out of my store.
You can shit out of here. I paid $6 for it.
Although I have lost receipts. I always forget that Costco checks your receipt as you're leaving, and for some reason, I can never find the receipt. So I sort of feel this guy's pain.
You fucking punk.
Yeah, you fucking punk faggot. That's what I say to the Costco checkout people.
Fucking piece of shit, nigger.
Wholesale motherfuckers!
Hey, is that Peter Boys you want, sir?
Price Club faggots!
Sir. Just the way you give me, you know, I paid $6 for that.
No, you didn't. You haven't paid anything.
Lying piece of shit, $6. I paid for this.
I need you to leave my building right now.
I'm showing the cops, dude. I paid for
my stuff.
Ooh, that was a smooth move. So this guy, they confiscated the items that he is accused of stealing, right? They set it down on a counter, and the guy came back, and he's like, hey, I'm going to show the cops this. And obviously, he was going to run off with it, right? It was a clever way to get the item back, though. I'm just going to take this so I can show the cops.
I need you. No.
No, man, fucking
you
fuck
just
you.
Need to leave.
Okay, you go suck a fucking dick too, you fucking faggot punk.
Yes, I can.
Hey, excuse me if there's kids in here.
Yeah, there is.
Sir, go ahead. I apologize.
I need you. Excuse me if there are any real N-words here.
Okay, but I'm paying for what?
Sorry.
I'm asking you to leave my building.
You're just a figurative nigger.
God, but you're not going to charge me for sin, because I don't want to steal you, asshole.
Okay. Yeah, no one is black here, by the way. What's he throwing around the N-word?
I need to leave.
Just a figure of speech.
I need yours.
Figure of hate speech, am I right, blacks? Fist bump. I think that's pretty much it. He kind of walks away from the store. He keeps coming back.
Dude, take the camera off, you fuckhead.
I'm on private property.
You're a private nigger, you fucking punk.
You spit on me again, and you're going to have a broken face, brother. You spit on me again, you're going to have a broken face. I guarantee it.
You fuck your ass up, motherfucker.
Twice your size, dude.
I tear your ass up, dude.
You know what? We got little kids here. You're going to stop right now. You're going to stop this second. You're going to walk away, and you're going to shut.
Guy cameraman there. All right. A couple more short clips. I got to say thanks to Ant in the DV Discord. He posted a video of someone taking a hit off a bong, and unfortunately, I don't know if it goes down the wrong way or he's just a lightweight pussy. But he can't handle the hit. That's him. That's the guy laugh. I think he's retarded. I think that's part of the problem. So there he was laughing, and now he's going to take the hit here. All right. So far, so good. That was a pretty big, healthy hit. Oh, going back for seconds. Why does he do that? I can't figure out if he's got a problem or if he's trying to be funny. Regardless, he's having some issues with that hit. What, did he, like, drink the bong water? Oh. Getting a little juicy. Get it all out. Oh. Okay, well, oh. It's turning into vomit, just like a slurry. Went from liquid. Oh,
there's more there. Oh.
It's like sausage gravy. Thick oatmeal coming out there. I was trying to figure out, like, well, there's like another 2 or 3 minutes to this video. I wonder if there's going to be another puke. No, it's the rest of the video is footage of him cleaning up the vomit off of the grass and throwing it away in the trash. I don't know why that needed to be filmed, but if you want to see it, the video is posted in our Discord. Remember a couple months ago, we featured an interesting cover, a reimagining, if you will, of Vanessa Carlton's 1,000 Miles. I actually loved this version.
Making my way through the hood with tall boo. All his homeboys think I'm cute.
She's holding a gun as she's doing that. Walking through the streets.
Riding around 10 to 5, toting his arm. Bet 9 and I've tried none. We shoot not the roof. And now you wanna know.
Now
I was rolling with your man.
Okay.
He picked me up in a coupe. I'm in a car, but I gotta watch my.
I love that she's dating a white guy in this video. That's very cute. Anyway, apparently Vanessa Carlton, and specifically 1,000 Miles, is very popular in the black rap community. I guess I could have just said rap, but that's racist. Anyway, here is a black man. Sorry, a man. A man rapper. A rapist. We just call them rapists. Aren't all black men rapists? All right, I'm sorry. Cracking myself up over here. All right, here is another version of 1,000 Miles.
Making my way through the hood, sipping this yak. Niggas about to get blown with the Mac.
I love this so much.
Riding around the block with a Glock. Yo ass finna get shot. That's the silencer. That's the grenade launcher. I'm finna kill you. I'm finna drill you. And now you bleeding. They play it.
You get the idea there. Love that. I want a whole CD filled with 1,000 Mile covers and remixes. All right, and with that, let's get into the crazy, bizarre, twisted, and fucked up news right now. For the sideshow, so you can grab tomorrow's sideshow exclusive program. You'll also pick up Tuesday's sideshow exclusive podcast, and of course, full access to the entire archive of programs. I've been at this since December 2004. When you sign up for DV's member site, you get access to every single episode of DV, well over 3,000 shows. Plus, like I mentioned, we do exclusive programs every week, usually 2 times a week. If you like the show, please consider supporting it, because this is how I make my living, and this is how the show continues. So thank you to all of my current and hopefully future Sideshow members. There is another way to help support us monetarily, patreon.com/distortedview. Yes, we have a Patreon account. Pledge a few bucks, and you get access to exclusive posts. You know, occasionally I'll do videos. You get access to a special voicemail line. Where I will play your calls first. Okay, check it out, patreon.com/distortedview. If you've got no money whatsoever, just tell as many people as you can about the show. That might help us out as well. All right, 3 very quick stories, then we'll get the hell out of here. First up, this one comes from New Orleans. Did I say that right? A man accused of threatening to blow up a Willie's Chicken Shack Tuesday night. Well, this is a very New Orleans story, isn't it? What? Why would anyone want to blow up a Willie's Chicken Shack? All right, yes, a man accused of threatening to blow up one on Tuesday night claimed to police, when confronted about the allegation, that his words were merely a reference to a bowel movement. He was going to run into a Willie's Chicken Shack and blow some mud. A massive bomb. Shit bombs. This is an interesting defense. Never heard this one before. Arthur Posey, age 30, was booked on charges in connection to a bomb threat after his story was not corroborated with the restaurant's employees. There was no talk of pooping by this man. He wasn't grabbing his butt, running around looking for a restroom. Wasn't hopping around on alternating feet going, I gotta go, it's coming out. I feel it. It's poking its head out. All right, where are we at here? Shortly after police were made aware of the bomb threat at the Canal Street restaurant, an officer confronted Posey inside a business in the next block where the officer saw Posey enter. Posey claims to the officer he told a male employee he was going to blow the bathroom up in reference to a bowel movement. However, police say a Willie's Chicken Shack employee told officers Mr. Posey never told him anything about a bathroom. So what, he just said, like, I gotta blow this place up. Well, maybe. I mean, it could have been about taking a shit. Come on. Posey faces two counts of communicating of false information of planned arson. Orleans Parish Magistrate Judge Harry Cantrell on Wednesday appointed the Orleans Public Defender's Office to represent Posey. He scheduled a mental competency hearing for November 29th. According to the warrant, the restaurant's manager said that a man, later identified as Posey, went into the restaurant and approached the food preparation area, then asked her what time the restaurant closed. She told the man that she didn't know when the restaurant closed, which is weird for an employee not to know when they close. The manager stated the man, who wore a green hat, blue jacket, and carried a white bag, then replied, y'all about to close right now, because I'm going to get a bomb and blow this place up. The bomb threat. See, that's a little more menacing than how Posey described it. And if you had to go to the bathroom, right, if shitting was imminent, you would run to the restroom. You wouldn't stop by the food preparation area to have a conversation about store hours. The bomb threat was reported just after 7 p.m. on Tuesday. The manager told police that she took the threat very serious and notified her general manager, who instructed her to call the police. Another Willie's Chicken Shack employee told police she heard Posey say he was going to get a bomb and put it under the middle table of the restaurant closest to the front door, which is not somewhere a turd would go, you know what I mean? At the time of his arrest, Posey was wearing a green hat, blue jacket, blue pants, and was carrying a white plastic bag. Just like the description of the man was given to the cops. So there you go. Poor Willie's. I'm so curious about Willie's Chicken Shack. Is that like a multi-state chain? Am I missing out on a Willie's Chicken Shack? I'm always down for some good fried chicken. You, guys, did you know that KFC has introduced chicken and waffles? This is a goddamn game changer. Not really, though, because everywhere offers chicken and waffles. God damn it, KFC, what's wrong with you? Still, I'm very excited about some of their options. You can get the chicken and waffles platter or some sort of sandwich where the waffles are the buns. Again, I wish I could say that KFC is really innovating here, but White Castle has been doing shit like this for a while with their waffle sandwiches. KFC has really forgotten how to innovate. All right, second story we have for you today. Police are investigating an assault involving several cans of SpaghettiOs in Pittsburgh. I'm surprised they still sell that shit. You know, I've talked to a lot of people. I don't know why I'm talking to people about SpaghettiOs, but it does come up occasionally. I have strange conversations with people. Look, I'm very socially awkward, and so I say weird things when I don't know what else to say, and questions pop out like, did you eat SpaghettiOs as a kid? Meanwhile, I just met this person like 2 minutes ago. This is what I want to know about them. I need to know your history with SpaghettiOs. But I've talked to people about SpaghettiOs, and everyone has eaten this shit. I've tried it once. Like, I think I was over a friend's house or something, and the mom was like, you guys want some lunch? And her idea of lunch was warming up SpaghettiOs. That's a pretty shitty lunch, right? You know, when I had friends come over to my house, it would be a big deal. We'd all go out to, like, McDonald's or something. Don't get me wrong, that's shitty food too, but you get the toys and the Happy Meals. Kids love that shit. Or my mom would make like pancakes, or my dad would be like cooking out on the grill and stuff. Fucking microwaving SpaghettiOs. Zero effort was put into the thought of feeding your guests, but whatever. All right, oh, but I think SpaghettiOs were just nasty. Also those Chef Boyardee ravioli things. Oh, those were nasty too. The sauce is the problem. I'm Italian. Sauce is very important to me. Mwah. All right, so let's see what happened here. Maybe this woman was served SpaghettiOs and she's like, what? This is a date. And she beat him over the head with a SpaghettiOs can. Who knows? Police are investigating an assault involving several cans of SpaghettiOs in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. WTAE-TV. Tay in the way. Chicka-chicka-chicka-pay. Nell is a reporter over there. A woman attack a tea and a tie in a why. Yeah. This is Nell reporting for WTAE. Thank you, Nell. For more election results, stick with WTAE. Tay in the way. All right, WTAE-TV reports a woman told police she was meeting someone in the city's Terrace Village neighborhood last month when another woman approached her and began throwing canned spaghetti at her vehicle. The victim says the suspect tried stabbing her with a knife, and she was sliced in the finger. Police say the victim managed to get away, taking the attacker's purse with her. Items in the purse helped authorities identify the suspect as 59-year-old Eileen Gettleman. Come on, Eileen. You had to know you were going to get caught. Police say the victim's car was left with a broken back window and a splattering of red sauce and pasta. Eileen Gettleman has been charged with aggravated assault and criminal conspiracy. No attorney is listed in the court documents. Come on, Eileen. Get a lawyer. Tula, rula, tula, rula. By the way, that was one of the greatest Halloween costumes I saw this year. I'm sure people have done this in the past, but it was a woman covered in cum, and she has a Hello, My Name is Eileen sticker on it, and I thought that was kind of funny. There was... Come on, Eileen. Final story we have for you. I just think raccoons are the cutest goddamn animals, and I want one as a pet. I knew two kids, because I lived in a redneck white trash neighborhood, apparently. I knew two kids who actually had raccoons as pets. Is that normal? One lived in a trailer. And on the side of her trailer, they constructed this huge cage for the raccoon to live. And the other kid I knew lived in a two-story house and just had a raccoon that was basically free roaming. And I was so afraid to go. I never went in his house because he would be always covered in scratches. And he would say things like, oh, the raccoon doesn't like strangers. Well, the raccoon doesn't seem to like you either. Can only imagine what it does to strangers in the house. I was always very curious. Like, I would drive up. I can't remember how old I was, if I was 16 at the time or younger. So either my parents would drive me up to his house and we'd pick him up and then go wherever we're going to go. But I would never enter the house. But I do think they're adorable. And there's a lot of neat YouTube or Facebook videos with cute raccoons. Rabid animals are no laughing matter, though. Well, that's not necessarily true. We've laughed at a few rabies patients before on the program. The rabies virus can infect the central nervous system, resulting in disease and death. That's according to the CDC. But that happens after a host of increasingly scary symptoms. You know, if you think you might have rabies, you'll probably first suffer from partial paralysis, agitation. So far, this article is describing me to a T. Maybe I have rabies. Let's see. Partial paralysis. There's always something numb or hurting on me. I can't feel parts of my body or my toes. You know, it's either diabetes or rabies. Partial paralysis. Yeah, check. Agitation. Check. Hallucinations. Check. Hydrophobia. Oh, I have a huge problem with water. I mean, I know I need it to live. But by and large, water's bullshit. You'd think after all these years on planet Earth, we as humans would have come up with a better way to clean ourselves and nourish ourselves than fucking water. Something that tastes better and is not all wet. Seriously, do you guys like the feeling of being wet? I don't, especially in the winter. You know, you get in the shower, and okay, it's nice and hot water first, but then the second that water turns off, you're like, holy fucking shit, I'm dripping wet, I'm cold. This is a nightmare. And you need to use so much of it to get clean. You know how many gallons of water people use when they shower or fill a bathtub? I'm sick of these scientists working on shit that doesn't matter, like AI, neural nets, and bots and shit. Every day I see like a new Twitter thread that's like, hey, I'm a scientist and I fed a neural network 5,000 scripts to Olive Garden commercials and now the bot can generate its own. We've got a real problem with water here. Specifically me not liking it. So yeah, I'm hydrophobic, I guess. A British man, I'm pretty sure I have rabies. I've been foaming at the mouth for like 7 years on the show. No one's noticed. A British man and two children died in Morocco after they were bitten by a rabid cat. So, you know, rabid things exist. It was not surprising that when people in the city of Milton, West Virginia saw raccoons behaving weirdly, they involved the local police. Officers staked out the area where the suspect animals were hanging out, looking for any signs of the masked perps. But when they caught two of them, they realized they were dealing with a different kind of issue. These raccoons weren't rabid, they were drunk. The raccoons apparently had been feasting on crab apples that had fermented on the trees, causing the small animals to walk around staggering and disoriented. Two more symptoms I share. Turns out they appear to be drunk on crab apples, police said in their official statement to the community. The apprehended animals were held in custody and allowed to sober up in what can only be deemed a raccoon drunk tank. Okay, I gotta mention this real quick. There's this, you know, I'm on whatever news site this is from, and they've got ads just plastered everywhere on this site, on the sidebar, throughout the ad. There's four or five Kroger ads and stuff. But then there's this one that I've seen multiple times. It drives me up the wall because it's like four signs your heart is quietly failing you, sponsored by Physio True. And then there's a picture of a guy's leg, right? And the leg, it's just like from, I guess, below the knee all the way down to the foot, right? And you see like some wrinkles on the foot or whatever, some lines, and then like he must have been wearing tube socks, right? You can see where the tube socks were pressing down on his legs. And is that supposed to be a sign that your heart is quietly failing you, that you get like an indentation when you wear socks? Because if so, then my heart's failing me. Doesn't that happen to everyone? Like if you're wearing long socks that are tight, it presses down on your leg, right? And then it makes an indentation for a while until you take the socks off. I hope that's the case because, I mean, I've always had that, though. Maybe my heart's always been failing me. I don't know what the fuck. Who the fuck cares? This is ridiculous. The article does go on to say that other animals have been found drunk. Officers in Gilbert, Minnesota, for example, received reports of under-the-influence birds. Now, that's dangerous because they swoop and they run into things. They were flying into windows and cars, acting all confused. That's according to Police Chief Ty Tecker. An early frost meant that berries had fermented before the birds flew south for the winter. So when the birds ate the berries, they got all drunk. That, my friends, is your distorted news for Thursday. Let's do a couple voicemails and get the hell out of here. Well, guys, I'm so sorry the show was posted late today. If you follow me on Twitter, you kind of know what's going on. Halfway through, I've been having this problem. I kind of mentioned it a while ago that occasionally when I would hit record in Logic, the program I used to record this podcast, it would just crash. And then some days it would happen over and over and over, and some days it would just happen once or twice, and that would be it. And it started happening after I upgraded to the newest version, the newest version of Mac OS, which is called Mojave. This was shortly after I was like, you guys know why I use Macs, huh? You want to know why I use Macs? Because they're reliable. Yeah, they cost more. Yeah, it's a fucking bitch to shell out that money. But you know what? It's worth it because the software is so great. Fucking Windows computers crash left and right every time I open it. And then, boom. Ever since then, I've been having nothing but problems with Logic. Every time I click to record, boom, crash, boom, crash, So it happened before I got this new computer, which is the iMac. Remember, I told you guys that I sold the iMac to Lord Douche's uncle. Yeah, yeah. But it started to happen before that. So I installed the new version of Mac on the laptop. It started, you know, logic started crashing. Then when I got this this new iMac, it continued to crash. So I chalked it up to it being a Mac OS Mojave problem. And I thought, well, all I got to do is roll back to the previous OS. And luckily, I had an external drive that I could boot from. It did not fix the problem. I was racking my goddamn brains out. So the way I record the show, and I'm sure you guys care about this, but I've got a file. Right, I've got a logic file, and then I use as a template, and it's got all my tracks, and it's got like whatever effects I want to put on it, like a noise gate, and blah 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 blah, and I call it, you know, Timmy's template, because I'm a retard. And so when I start up the show, I load up Timmy's template, and I'll start recording the show, and then I'll save it under, you know, the file name that I want to use it, like today's date or whatever. Well, what I have figured out is that in that one file, the Mac does weird things with files, right? So I've got this file that is today's show that I can actually open that file. It's a package. And in that package, it's got all the little bits that I've used, right? All the sound effects, all the audio things, all the, you know, all my fuck-ups. Basically, anything that I've recorded, it's in there. And what happens over time, all of that shit, it gets bloated because I'll be recording a lot of stuff before I save it under the new file name, I guess. So under the template file name, it has tons and tons of just audio files from you know, months worth of shows. It just gets too big. It's like gigs and gigs. This file is like, I don't know, 8 gigs, 10 gigs. Like, it's massive. And that's the problem, I think, because I can go in. Mac is pretty cool. You can go into this package, and then I just deleted all of the audio files, and now the file is like 30 megs, right? It's just like nothing. And now everything's working. So I think I figured out the problem, and I feel good about that. In case you're using Logic the same way I do and you're having that problem, just create a new file, right? Don't reuse old ones. And if you do, go in there and delete all the shit you don't need. All right, now we can do some voicemails. Now that I got that off my chest, we can do some voicemails now. There are many ways to contact me. Of course, our standard voicemail line, 206-666-4463. You can also find me on Twitter and Instagram at DistortedView, facebook.com/DistortedViewShow. We've got a Discord. There's a link on DistortedView.com. And we got a subreddit over there at DistortedView.reddit.com. Or something like that. Something similar to that. r/distortedview. All right, let's first check in with a couple patrons here. Oh, I'm sorry. Hold on. Since I'm booting, I'm using a different operating system here, or a different hard drive. I have to switch over my audio. There we go.
Hey, Timmy Boo, Tony Prolapse, the feller who wants to join the Navy.
Tony Prolapse called in a while ago, mentioning that he's going into the Navy. Then a bunch of callers said, what are you thinking? You're crazy. Yesterday, or the last program we did, which I think was a Sideshow exclusive one, a caller said the best branch you could go into if you're smart is the was it Air Force and U.S. Coast Guard. Stay away from the Navy.
Wants to join the Navy. I've just taken a couple of the practice tests. I haven't signed anything.
Oh, good.
I don't sign anything unless I know what I want. Thank you from some guy in Japan. I actually looked into the Coast Guard, but I felt I wasn't qualified enough. And I actually scored like an 86 on my ASVAB. Sorry.
I don't think that's not a good score, is it?
I practiced ASVAB. And the Navy is trying to get me to sign ASAP.
But that's how they do.
I've heard if you score above like an 82, other branches are going to call you. So I'm just going to wait and see who calls me.
Oh, okay. 80, I guess 86 is a good score.
Or finds out, but yeah.
Yeah.
I did not know the Navy.
Don't feel pressured. You wait.
For work.
You want these branches to court you.
Probably makes good sense on why they want me to join really quick.
Yeah.
Also, I'm not crazy enough to be a Marine. No offense, but those guys are fucking insane.
Again, just remember, you've got something they want. You're in total control here. You make them work for it, okay?
Hello, Ivanovich, Vladimir Putin. So a couple days ago, you were playing Chris Hansen audio, and you were speculating when they were referring to Viagra. They were, he had to call it the, he had to,
or Cialis, yeah,
about the, not say the name. He could not say Viagra. They were like a little pill.
Yeah,
you must call the doctor if it lasts longer than 4 hours. And you speculated that perhaps they have sponsors. That the show is sponsored by another erectile dysfunction medication. Yeah, Tim, I'm sure an erectile dysfunction medication wants to sponsor a show about catching pedophiles. That really works, right?
I didn't even think about that. Well, you know, all those daytime TV shows are sponsored because it's old people who watch it, right? And the thing is, like, Crime Watch Daily isn't just about, like, Chris Hansen hunting down pedophiles. That's, like, one segment that he does, like, a few times a year. You know what I mean?
Secondly, a gentleman called...
That is kind of funny, though. They'd be doing a Viagra commercial. These predators.
Himself ex-military, and who was... telling Tony Prolaps that he should not join military. Isn't the term ex-military reserved for a, when you are, what's it called?
Dishonorably discharged.
Dishonorably discharged?
Yeah.
I believe you are former military if you were honorably discharged and ex-military.
Are you saying that guy's a liar or he was dishonorably discharged?
Dishonorable discharge. So it just seemed a little strange that someone calling themselves ex-military, I question whether or not this gentleman was ever actually in the military.
Stolen valor!
Ex-military.
We played those clips.
Okay, well, that's all for now, Tim.
Okay.
Hello to my friends in the Discord. Vladimir out.
Yeah, Vladimir Putin's in the Discord. If you want to talk to him, chat with him, you can find him over there. All right, let's do one more here.
Hey, Tippy Bull, come here, mate. Just kidding, it's your fairy little sideshow faggot here, unicorn hamster. I'm calling because I'm calling for work, so don't mind the noise. I'm calling because I have a new idea for a little segment on the show. I mean, I'm thinking, like, the whole deep web thing, like, maybe you can find some good materials.
Yeah.
In the deep web, and, like, you can call it Distorted View Daily Extreme Web Edition.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Wasn't there like that African preacher who was talking about like gays doing scat and fisting and stuff? And he's like, it goes deeper! Deeper!
Thing,
that could be the name of the segment. Distorted View goes deeper!
I don't know what you're doing. I ain't calling to complain about the audio when you play some new parts. And I had to turn the bus, man. Fuck everybody. Keep doing what you're doing. You've been doing a long time. And the whole P.O. Box thing, I don't know nothing about that.
Oh, yeah. I haven't checked my P.O. Box lately.
They never fucking mail shit. I pay all my bills online. Never mind. Your fucking key thing is fucked up, and I'm pissed off now. Fuck off.
Okay. All right. Thank you very much. Oh, there we go. That is all. You know who I got a message from after I did that Brad Carter show? Remember Paul and Jeanette, the PK and J show? Paul texted me. I don't know how he got my phone number. He used to text or whatever. And he caught it. He watched it, which is kind of cool. So hi, Paul, if you're listening again. He said he had to stop listening to the show because I was playing too much shit porn. Like, that was his line that he... But I told him I haven't been playing a lot of it lately. I've been pretty good. So you can come back and listen to the show again. So hopefully Paul's listening. That is all the time we have on this edition of the show. Want you guys to email me, show at distortedview.com. distortedview.com is our official website. Voicemail line for you, 206-666-4463. That's 206-660-GOD, as in, oh God.
You suck, you stupid model!
Spread the distortion, STD, tell all your friends about the podcast. Remember, tomorrow's show is going to be Sideshow exclusive, and then this weekend I'll come back and do another program for everyone. So be on the lookout for all of that. Until then, have a great day. Bye, everybody!
I would love to rape a rooster.